what we got here, Stephen, is somebody who's a top world-class businessman in his own business arena. This guy's not somebody you want to mess with. Now, he's been threatened many, many times. He's gotten into a couple of gunfights. I strongly urge you to think very carefully about your questions. And don't attempt to try to fool him by putting him on camera, except maybe in a silhouette or something.
Would you like to know a couple of things?
I want to know everything.
If you're looking for validation in terms of what Mark and Kathy have laid on the table, hey, is it real? Yeah, it's real. And when you consider that you have members of the judiciary, law enforcement, high-level place business people, politicians involved, you understand what I'm just saying to you? It's people who shape how you see the world, tell you what's important, what's not important. If you choose to take a deep look at it and do your own research, fine. You'll find out for yourself. Hope you're fast on your feet, and hope you're capable of dodging bullets, because you might run into some. These are serious people.
Every time I turned the proverbial corner, Stephen, I ran into stuff that is just totally 100% outside of my realm of experience, and hence of believability. I mean, it's bad enough to hear this stuff, but it's even worse to get it validated.
Kathy, you ready?
When I was 22 years old, my vaginal muscle, it was cut. And then once that happened, where there was more movement with the muscle can actually protrude out the vaginal opening. And that was carved by somebody that was a very controlling person and was aware of the effects of trauma on the human mind.
They used an X-Acto knife to do that?
A series of them. I didn't have any anesthesia, so I remember it very distinctly.
Is there a lot of bleeding?
It was so uncomfortable. I remember crawling into the bathroom and getting in the bathtub.
It seems to me like more of a ritualistic type of, I mean, carving, and not just carving, but an actual face, something into there.
I see the part that sticks out. There's a little, like a really long nose. And then right above it, there are two eyes. And there's a mouth that smiles underneath it.
Mostly what was done was what is considered outside of the vagina on the vulva. There were several incisions made, which made one flap of skin that looks like a nose, and slits were cut in to look like eyes, and even a mouth.
That's what you've been through. Haven't you been through the worst of it, do you think?
Yeah. Well, I'm not afraid of anything except maybe not getting the word out if that could be construed as a fear.
Yeah. pull that ball.
And this word is getting out regardless. I mean, we've won. We won big.
This right here is dragon's breath. These are all armor-piercing, exploding shells. This thing would make an armored personnel carrier completely debilitated. You know, New York second, as they say.
And you keep it in your bedroom?
I keep it right beside my head, along with a .45 loaded with similar shells. Not that I'm paranoid. It's just that, you know, I'd like to squeeze one last one off if some idiot wants to come in here.